Can you just really bring a mouse to use?
I run everything just in case. You know, I don't know. I do like the trackpad though. I hate regular laptop trackpads.
I've not noticed.
They're so bad.
A substantial decline.
All right, go beneath the TV, small man. Is it Rogue 06 or
no? Home dad. See.
Home dad.
Home dad.
Oh wait, am I connected to home dad already? Nope.
God damn it.
Hurry up.
Where did I put my flashlight?
Why?
Okay. Zero.
Oh, well, I'm just drinking espresso. That's a hot guacamole.
Yeah.
Alright, what's up?
Zero. Six. All letters are capital, by the way.
Yep.
E, E, 7, 1, 2, 8, 4, C, 5, 0, A, 5,
Jesus Christ.
F, E. Okay, guys, we got a trailer coming in just a moment. It's goddamn secure. Okay.
Alright, it's working.
It working.
Oh. Dude, this Orlando stuff is getting out of hand.
He's what?
This Orlando shit is getting out of hand.
Oh my god, yes. Let's run inside and check
out the show. It's too close, though. It's too close.
Yeah. I'm not.
I go to Orlando clubs. Occasionally. It's fucked up.
Yeah.
That's very fucked up. And it was like the biggest one.
Yeah.
That's what really gets me. Sandy Hook, all that stuff, dude. It was all less than this. Huh.
Yo.
What's that? Oh shit. Is stream live?
Yeah, we've been up for a while.
Oh, well, I'm glad. I was gonna say some really embarrassing stuff.
Mic is on. It's not working out. It's three seekers. Capri, Zarazon, Daxos, and Quaithe, who are kind of like the three wise men of the Bible. They come after a miraculous birth beneath a special star and give gifts to a possible prophesied savior. But is this anyway, Game of Thrones?
It's a Song of Ice and Fire analysis, actually.
Wow, I was so interested. She wears a red mask and calls herself Quaithe of the Shadow. Like Melisandre, she says she's a Shadowlander from a Shire. I just put it as playing gaming talk show.
Oh, you put it in gaming talk show?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's this category. That was a great intro. They became the number one games and hobbies podcast just based on the intro. It's awesome.
No. Flash.
Is Flash on the CW?
Hmm?
What is Flash on?
CW? Yeah.
What else is on the CW?
Well, now Supergirl. Hey, this guy.
Oh. We've got him.
I don't know what is... the weirdest like lens flare I've ever seen. Arrow, Supergirl, Legend of Tomorrow. I don't know who this guy is.
Who? Jackie T? It's not Jackie T. Oh, I don't know that name. Oh, it's an orchestra. Final Fantasy 15.
Hell yeah.
No, it's maybe. Not going to be Final Fantasy.
We don't know.
I hope it's not. The fuck is that Persona 5?
I have no idea. Look at that lightning, though.
This is a great intro.
I said goddamn.
I wish we were at E3.
Yeah, that'd be rad. If only we were, like, industry insiders.
Or had money.
Or talent. No. It's only open to people in.
Oh, yeah. I forgot about that.
Okie dokie. We are good on sound. Cool.
And we don't need to get that close to the mic in order to sound good.
Yeah, I was enjoying that, though. That was a good part of last stream.
You're like, well, howdy fucking do.
What was that?
I'm making fun of you.
I never said that at all.
No, but you should have.
Why?
I don't know.
Should I send this man cut to Oliver Heldens?
Yes, please.
I already have, but he never opens them.
I'm going to assume, yeah. It just sounds right.
Wait, why would you just assume yeah?
Oh, because he's famous.
I mean, that makes sense. Alright. What was his intro?
I'm
very tired.
I'm convinced it might be...
Do you have the live follower and everything up in the other one?
What's that?
Can you pull up the live follower and the other ones on the... I want, like, the actual Twitch page, like the dashboard.
What do you mean?
Like the dashboard on Twitch.
Yeah.
I'll pull that up.
It's bare bones as shit, though.
I just like it. It's a hot one. $316?
What?
When did that happen?
You're from Chad?
Yeah.
Oh, go to
no,
settings.
It's there, it's there, I got it.
But you can take out the video and it won't, like...
No, I just won't.
It won't cause lag or anything.
I can't watch the video though as well. We're also behind on it.
Yeah.
We're extremely behind. Alright, here's what we're gonna do. What is happening?
Fuck if I know. Here, I'll give you this.
This is a very odd intro. What's that?
It can just pull up
the chat.
Chat. Yeah.
Cool. Awesome.
Open.
Let us log in with the secret password.
Look at that guy. He's got one curl.
He's a very interesting
going
conductor.
Crazy.
The curl going crazy. Why can't I log in to my own blog?
Chat only.
Cool. I mean, it's not doing anything.
No.
We'll chill everything out. I'm just covered in Apple products now. I'm fucking Apple. Home. Take this away from me. Alright, NightOwl.Games logging in. WordPress, the best blogging. Oh god, no! Just immediately.
Yep. Yeah.
Look at the Stewie controller.
What?
I hope that's real. The Stewie controller?
Dude, they've, like...
They bashed it, I know.
Long since confirmed it's not.
Yeah, I know, I know, I know.
SIE presents...
Last of Us 2. No.
Last Guardian.
Oh, is it? Okay.
Is it not?
I don't know. No.
No, 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 no.
Yo, is this the Detroit game? No, no, this is the Horizon Zero Dawn?
This is not.
I have no idea what any of this is.
This is not Detroit.
No, this is Detroit game. It's coming out. Is this Horizon Zero Dawn, the dinosaur game?
I don't know.
They delayed this until February, though.
What for?
A test. She taught you to hunt, yes?
Yes, sir.
Then show me what you know. I am hungry.
Oh,
oh, this is the, it's gonna be the, Norse gods one.
Yeah. I'm okay
Man,
with that.
Man, I don't know, I don't really, I'm just not a God of War player, so I don't really care, but, cool.
Oh, this
seems pretty sweet, though.
Yeah.
Yeah. I just realized that, too. It's pretty good. Yeah, this seems a lot more interesting than any other God of War that I've ever seen, because they're finally giving depth to Kratos. Because Kratos is, like, the least, like, all that he
okay,
is anger.
There was depth.
No, there's no
there
depth.
There was some depth.
All that he was just anger. It's, like, the worst character ever.
I remember I subscribed to PSM, PlayStation Magazine, and they had like a demo disc of God of War, but because I was like 9 at the time or whatever, I forget how old I was. I was not old enough to buy an M game, so I just played the ever-living shit out of that demo, and it was only the Hydra level, so you only fought the Hydra. Good times.
Do not simply react. Be calm and plan.
Dude, walking. Gotta love it.
There it is.
Hold. Idiots.
What are you doing? Now his guard is up. Only fire.
Only fire. When I tell you to fire.
I'm sorry.
There has to be one person who has like a Kratos tattoo. Like that whole like
that would be lame.
Disgusting red thing.
Oh Jesus, across the whole chest.
Find it.
Woolly man.
Oh, this must be good.
Oh shit.
Ice axe. The button mashing is real. Quick time events, we're good. We got everything we need. This looks like...
Don't hate, just yet.
This looks way different than any other God of War.
I mean...
Gameplay-wise.
No.
I'm talking about, like, instead of beating up like 30 things, it could be 30.
That's gonna come.
Yeah, but this is still, Yeah, like that guy got really into it. Did you see
that's
him?
The guy playing it.
He was like, oh, yeah. No, I get that. I was just saying. He got really into that last hit. That was pretty bad.
You know, if you give me my life,
you have yet to do that.
I need a chance.
You have a chance.
I need another.
Then find that deity.
I can't tell who the voice actor is, but I really like his voice. Are these just like giant? Yeah, that's a giant.
There we go.
Oh, shit.
Here's a chance. Show me your ready.
The fuck is that?
A giant. I'm... Frost giant?
I like the pillar.
I would love to see, like, an E3 demo where the dude just gets wrecked.
Dude, that happened. Like, well, there's been a few where people have fucked up. And there was one where the Skyward Sword demo, did you see that?
Yeah, where it just didn't work.
There was so much interference because of all the cell phones and shit.
That's bullshit, and you know it.
That's what happened, dude.
That's bullshit.
No, that's what happened.
No,
that's,
it didn't.
How are you going to deny that?
Because it's not how that works.
Oh, my God. I'll show you proof.
It's an IR scanner.
No, it's
a Wiimote is an IR.
Sorry, maybe it wasn't from the cell phones, then it was from other devices. But
okay,
there was a bunch of problems.
It definitely wasn't. It just didn't work.
I'm sorry.
They're doing what we're doing, but better.
Yeah.
Yeah. Cool. Spartan rage. Wow, that kind of bothers me. Wait, is Kratos immortal?
No. Kratos has a beard now, though. That beard hype is pretty good.
Jesus!
That was a good hit. It's still God of War. Yo, I heard this one was gonna be Norse gods, though.
It is in Norway.
That's what's up.
Like, you can tell, like, where the runes and stuff.
And the snow giant. Shoot him in the fuck,
thing. Idiot. This kid sucks.
Yeah, this kid's a terrible companion. There's no Ellie. He doesn't even need him.
This kid's the worst.
$20 if the kid betrays you later on in the game.
$20 if the kid dies.
Jesus Christ.
I am so sorry.
Your deal is getting away.
Kratos is still just a heartless asshole.
Yeah, surprise.
Why did it say offline? I never understood that.
Mm-hmm.
Dalfman discovered.
Mike.
Yeah.
That will pick up.
Yeah, I was just throwing it.
Hey, I thought your mother taught you to hunt. Then it is time for you to learn. Wait for my mark.
Learn to fucking aim.
Learn to fucking aim.
He's shooting on the wrong side.
Get in the fucking robot. Oh, look at the live conductor. This is pretty high. Now shoot him. It was a terrible noise. I didn't like that at all. Deborah.
Is it a reindeer or an elk?
It's a Norse god elk.
Oh no, he's a deer earlier, so I'm assuming reindeer.
Probably.
Morality system? Or is this a cutscene?
A cutscene. I'm Kratos. I will murder this elk for you, little
No, because it looked like it was like kind of like going back and forth and like.
It might be a morality thing.
I dig the live orchestra, and I dig Kratos' beard.
Kratos' beard is hype.
Kratos' beard is hype.
Pure hype. Triforce hype.
What did you say?
It's a Triforce hype, but we're done with that.
Ba-da-dum-bum-bum. I was playing 64 yesterday on your Wii U, and I forgot how fucking ridiculous those controls are. Because I remember where to go, what to do, and like how to do it, but my timing is just so off with like... long jumps.
Oh. Is it gonna end or is the gameplay gonna continue now that the dragon's here? It's gonna end.
Why
God of War 4? God of War : It's just God of War? It's just God of War?
I'm gonna say yes.
No, it's gotta be like God of War : Norse Gods.
Stacy 10 times, this game is looking good. Yes, you are correct. Please welcome to the stage, Sean Layden. I don't have any doubts
hey,
about...
Hey, Sean Layden.
Yeah, I don't have any doubts about, like, the looks of any of the games. Like, I know that's not what you meant. But, like, I don't have any doubts about, like, the looks of games coming out.
Yeah?
No.
I think they're all gonna be fine, yeah, but gameplay wise.
Especially with just the processing power we like we have. Yo.
Yes.
Good evening. Good evening everyone and welcome. What a way to start the show, huh? The live demo of God of War. Right now also a special thank you and a shout out to our
Sean Layden is so high.
Composer, the soundtrack to God of War, Mr. Bear McCreary.
Dude's good.
He's got that hair.
Here tonight with his awesome orchestra, and they'll be performing all evening. So that's really exciting for all of us.
There's like two people that clap for
that. That's sad.
Before we go any further, I think it's important that we take a moment to address the heartbreaking tragedy of Orlando this past weekend. A perfect event like that, carried out by a madman, really underscores our need for the greater love, tolerance, and respect of people of all kinds. On behalf of the PlayStation community, I just want to say our thoughts with the victims and families and community of
Orlando. Fuck.
We stand four square with them. We hope that in this week of preps our gaming celebration.
It's pretty crazy that he was like not prepped for this and then now has to like deal with it.
Yeah, no.
It's interesting.
The PlayStation community stands four square with our friends and fans and the LGBT community as well.
See, I think that was important.
It's necessary.
Especially at something where someone said this earlier on Twitter, that like most of what Xbox was like promoting was like mass murder simulation.
Oh.
Yeah.
Fuck. God of War is mass murder simulation though.
But it's not like people. So there's like the dissociation.
Yeah.
We're proud to be part of a vast and expansive team of storytellers, artists, engineers, musicians, and programmers and actors. The massive and sometimes tiny teams who tirelessly create works of art that we find ourselves getting lost in. And that is what tonight is all about. For the next hour, we will, we hope to, astound you with a lineup of games that are both dazzling and transformative, with a few surprises along the way. So, without further ado, I'm proud to take you on this journey to some of the great games coming out on PlayStation. Please enjoy this.
Okie dokie.
You're underway.
Updating their servers as we speak.
That's fair. Where's
the wiki? Our only hope for survival. I remember when the planes fell out of the skies.
What is this? Is this Horizon? Stopped running. I don't know what Ben's doing.
When the turbines shut down and the world went dark.
Oh, they made
Bubsy 3D. Maybe this is Bubsy 3D too.
Yeah.
I didn't realize Ben did Bubsy 3D.
Oh, they made is this Siphon Filter? Is this Siphon Filter? They make a new Siphon Filter.
We'll see.
And some of us sort of lost our minds.
Dude, he's dead. They've only made the portable Uncharted.
I'm so sorry they made Bubsy 3D.
They made Fight for Fortune. That's the card game. The Uncharted card game.
Okay.
I lived by a code. I have no idea what this is. I feel like I should.
And living meant more than surviving.
Goddamn liar!
So yeah. I remember how it all went down.
Siphon Filter type, but I don't think this is Siphon Filter. I also never played Siphon Filter, but I have heard good things.
Riding the open road.
The hair physics.
The touch of your
skin. Looks so much better than like the Lara Croft one from earlier.
I remember you.
Did you see that?
Lara Croft one?
Lara Croft.
Oh, I was like, what?
A bounty hunter. A mercenary.
So
and for me, the broken
what
road
is this?
Is all that's left. But I'll always remember.
Sad motorcycle man.
Days gone.
Days gone? Days gone? What is days gone?
No idea.
Okay. Here we go. This is great. I love how there's a live feed too.
Oh, dude, this is so funny.
Meaty Molecule game is revealed. That'd be hype as fuck. PlayStation Move and Morpheus. They're gonna do PS4.5.
No, I thought they're not gonna talk about it.
No, they have to. They have
no, they're not going to.
Well, like, it's brought up in here as well.
They're gonna mention it, but I don't think they're gonna be like anything.
I'm pretty. Is this Last Guardian? All right. Holy shit.
I don't know what Days Gone is, but it looks kind of like Last of Us, the road-esque game.
But with motorcycles.
Yeah.
Is this Last Guardian?
It has to be. Yeah, yeah, oh yeah. See, in my opinion, Sony won last year because of Last Guardian.
That was a... Well, they took so fucking long, though.
I think they had a... Oh, okay, hell yeah.
Oh my god.
It's like so good. Hello, what is that?
Dude, what are they saying? There's the one theory that they're just gonna announce that The Last Guardian is out, like, tonight.
I would cry.
You'd have to go download it and play it.
Because the money in my savings account cannot get to my checking account.
It's also for PS4
4
exclusive.
Days. No, that's what I'm saying.
Oh, okay. You do transfer. You would buy a PS4 for it?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Honestly.
October 25th. Hype. That's pretty good.
Yeah, actually.
That's pretty good. October 25th.
I'm gonna say this, though. October 25th, but it's going to be pushed to holiday. That's my prediction.
Any idea where Days Gone trailer was happening?
Where?
Yeah.
No. Masters of the World. What's this? Oh, this is
this is Horizon Zero Dawn.
Yeah. I love the design of, like, this chick.
Oh, shit. my God. Horizon's gonna be so... It's not coming out until February, though. They already announced that.
It's okay.
Turn back! Corrupted machines in the valley!
I have to cross! I'm headed for the border!
Then may the goddess show mercy!
Acting.
Is it October 25th?
Yeah. I'm telling you right now. I'm saying it'll be September. They'll have an announcement calling a delay. Until holiday 2016.
Yeah.
That's my prediction.
That's one possibility.
Show walkers.
This is gonna be high.
Let's have a look.
Oh, dude, dinosaurs, robot dinosaurs. That's like two things I love.
It's like when you combine tits and anime.
To anime.
I should focus again. Got some weak spots.
What? A shadow looking at me.
But I need the components.
This reminds me, it looks like Enslaved Odyssey to the West.
What is it?
It looks like Enslaved. That was cool.
Yeah.
Ooh, got all the things. That's coming. Shit.
Oh, I like that.
The live switch.
They like the slowdown?
Yeah. That's like Lara Croft. Doesn't that happen there? Where you pull up the bow and everything?
Kind of.
Wow.
This stream is not too great.
Who said that?
No, I mean like...
Oh. I was like, oh, someone's hitting.
The bitrate.
No one's hitting.
Two explosive traps coming right up.
Cool, live crafting.
Mm-hmm.
I'm in.
I'm trying to think what this reminds me of.
Watch out! It's corrupted!
Oh shit. That was rad.
You did it. I came from Mother's Rise.
Corrupted the type of village.
Yes, and something worse. A demon.
A demon?
What are you
Ooh, choices.
So far this looks like a combination of Far Cry? I think that's what we played.
It was like Far Cry Primal, sort of, but like with robots.
No, that's not what I mean. Like, game-wise.
Oh, gameplay-wise?
Yeah.
Like, breaking things and then using the environment to build better things. Yeah.
I don't believe in demons, and I don't run when lives are at stake. Get out of here.
You're crazy!
And it's ice cold. Alright, cool.
The village. I'll never make it in time. Unless I get a mount. Broadheads. If I override one of those.
This is, okay. The choices thing reminds me of Bethesda. The gameplay itself, like the switching mechanic, reminds me of Far Cry.
Right.
But it, like, so far, it honestly looks like the best parts of those two. Which is a very good thing. Oh, that's so cool. You basically
rideable because you can hack them.
It looks like hacking. Yeah. You can broadside a boar. So what? Okay. Like, what's the purpose of the robots?
I think they're just like, it's like a planet that was just overtaken by robot dinosaurs. Like, they evolved.
Like, the robots evolved?
Yeah. I don't know.
Alright.
I don't know the premise, I may be completely wrong. But that that's what it appears to be me. That draw distance is right.
Jesus Christ, oh. He's still my heart.
What's that noise?
Did you hear about Skyrim HD?
Yeah.
And PC Master Race.
So I'm gonna get Skyrim HD. Yeah.
But you can just mod it. Like, I don't see why they mod it. They should have released Oblivion HD.
I agree.
Because there's no point to do Skyrim HD.
That
really
or even Morrowind.
Well, what the fuck was that? She was attacked by that.
Well, actually, to be fair, I think the popularity of Skyrim and like the accessibility of Skyrim is more than Morrowind or Oblivion. Now. I think if you announced a remaster when Skyrim came out and it wasn't Morrowind, it would have been like an uproar. Hold on. No.
Extended. This is ridiculous. It's like a Zelda thing though, where you have to break all the individual pieces.
Yeah.
When core is revealed.
This machine looks ancient. Where did it come from?
It's Metal Gear. It is not a new Metal Gear.
Santalarpus or Salantropus. It's Metal Gear DLC. Like, it's not even a new game.
This looks rad as shit, though. Like, hella rad.
Quantic Dream!
Shit. Look at this guy.
Dude, Quantic. Horizon Zero Dawn, Guerrilla Games, okay. Is this the Detroit game?
Did you know gorilla comes from the French word guerre, which means war? Get it? Oh, that's really cool.
Saving that kid is all on purpose. So either you deal with this fucking android now, or I'll take care of it.
Come any closer or I'll jump!
Help me! Help me!
Damn, Daniel.
Is she, like, is he an android? Because that's, like, a lot of
androids. Everyone's an android.
Oh, yeah.
Wait, is this Deus Ex? No, because Quantum wouldn't be working on Deus Ex. What is Quantum working on? Put the gun down and let the hostage go. I've spent my life taking orders. Now it's my turn to decide. Oh, it's David Cage.
Oh, shit.
That's fucked. Yeah, Detroit Become Human. This is the Detroit game.
Okay. I'm trying to figure out what's game. Oh, no, that's not a gameplay.
Androids who escaped the factory she was made to find sentience. Sweet. I heard about this one.
Look at that, look at that.
What's that?
Like the...
Are you armed? No. I have a gun. Drop it.
Touch him.
Touch him and I kill you. You can't kill me. I'm not alive.
What?
Tell that helicopter to get out of here.
Yeah, they did Heavy Rain and Beyond Two Souls. David Cage. So doesn't that make you think about these games differently now?
Beyond Two Souls, yes. Heavy Rain bothered me. But this is all about choice and whatnot. This is like...
I'm assuming it's a
narrative This reminds me of like Memento. Not Memento, what am I trying to say?
I trust you.
Shit, what's the movie? Where like... Kind of like Groundhog's Day. They keep reliving the same day until they get it right. But there's like a sci-fi version of it. I can't remember what it is. Is it 12 Monkeys?
Probably.
Can't fucking remember. Check this out. Look at this tree. That's badass.
You do like that? Oh, those are all the different choices.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
I mean...
This is our story.
But I also like how they used hyperreal graphics to represent an android, because it's like unnervingly real, but also you know it's an android.
Detroit Become Human?
I can dig this. Hey, PSVR.
Let's go.
Or kitchen.
I'm so fucking excited for PSVR.
Oh, dude.
We have to finally do a Let's Plays. It'll be so weird. If this is a horror game, I can't handle this.
Oh, I can do that.
A horror VR game?
Yeah.
Are you kidding me? It's way too...
I would have to get... You'd have to get, like, one of those, like, heart rate monitors that you can just, like, plug in.
This looks, like, way too much. Oh, 360 microphones and everything, too. It's so fucked.
PlayStation VR come with, like, the
dude,
hand controllers?
Marvel Hornets makes a VR game.
Dude, Slender. I think someone supported Slender to VR.
That'd be cool.
Yeah.
I don't really like Slender that much.
But I mean, like...
It's
as
the
it,
same concept. Yeah.
It was a fan-made free game.
Yeah, yeah.
It's not...
And then Slender 2 was terrible.
Oh, fuck,
God.
Man. It's Silent Hills. Silent
no,
Hill.
Not. No.
Silent Hill had...
I can't... Okay. Dude.
No, not Silent... I'm sorry, not Silent Hills. Wasn't it Silent Hill that had all the mannequins? This has to be a Silent Hill game. Did I tell you what I'm doing though? I'm gonna buy when the new AMD cards come out. I'm gonna buy one of them, and then when I go back to school, I'm gonna build. I'm gonna repurpose a new computer. And just get two AMD cards to run Crossfire. Just fucking crush VR. All the VR that I'm not going to buy. Ew.
Oh, God.
Oh, I'm... Okay, nope, I'm out.
This is too much.
I can't handle insects at all.
Nope. What is this fucking game?
See, what's most unnerving to me is that they've eliminated your peripherals. So you have this, like, vignetted field of vision.
Nope. Nope, nope, nope. Pyramid head. Pyramid help. Nope, 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 nope. VR horror is too much. I will not be purchasing any VR horror games. You're more than welcome to buy.
I can handle it.
If we get Streamhouse going, you're more than welcome to buy all the horror games you want, because it'll just be in the middle.
Why did it cut to that?
What the fuck am I supposed to do? God damn it.
Oh, they're using like all of the stage to show everything. That's rad. Okay. That's so cool.
What the fuck?
Music doesn't fit.
Nope.
Not at all. Seven.
What? It's gonna be VR Resident Evil 7. Do you think
fuck.
Wait, what? Is it? So it's gonna be back to survival horror. It's not gonna be 5 or 6. What was that? What's
Demo
that?
Tonight. PS Plus. Oh, shit. Mars, goddamn.
Dude, RE7? Is it? No. I'm not going to be happy about RE7 because they've screwed me on 5 and 6. And 4 is the only good one recent memory.
5 was okay. 6 had good parts. Which... But the problem was it had elements of 5 and 4. So, like, when you played Leon's missions, they were good. When you played Chris's missions, they were shit.
The full Resident Evil 7 will be playable from beginning to end with PlayStation VR.
No fucking way.
When it releases,
I am gonna probably shit my pants.
2016 is a seminal moment in virtual reality. The time has finally come for everyone to enjoy VR in their own home.
Is it a PS4 exclusive?
We have a combination of the necessary processing and
graphics my guess.
Power already built inside 40 million PS4s that have been sold worldwide.
Dude, VR so hype. I would actually... RE makes me think more... If it was Silent Hills, I wouldn't play it. But, like, Resident Evil, at least you can still, like, shoot and, like,
see,
be okay.
The thing, like, there was no implication of guns in this.
Oh yeah, you're right.
Because PlayStation 4 is a fixed platform, developers can fine-tune their games to the system to deliver the same transformative experience for all PlayStation VR owners. I'm happy to announce here that on October 13th, PlayStation VR will make
its debut
in
the United States. Isn't that the price of a PS4, though? How much are PS4 selling for now?
Hold on. October 13th?
Yeah.
More than 50 games will be available from launch until the end of this year.
What? 50 games at launch? Holy shit.
That includes some of the biggest franchises, along with brand new titles that will be born on PSVR. We invite those here tonight, after this experience, to come with us next door to the arena post-reception. We'll be able to have some PSVR kiosks set up so you can all have a go.
Wasn't it Morpheus was the VR thing?
Yeah.
Okay. What was the nickname for the Neo?
Was October 13th?
Yeah. 16th. 13th. 2016.
Yeah. Fuck yes. It's like
Neo is
birthday.
The 4.5.
My birthday
right?
present. Yes.
God. Oh, I want to see so much more of Resident Evil.
Watch your suit on those rocks. We don't know what kind of pathogens might exist here. We can't afford a breach.
This sounds like the girl from Firewatch.
Kind of. What is this?
Come on. We have to keep moving.
Oh, Probably.
This place isn't even on the star charts.
Holy shit. This is a great press conference. Firewatch 2, this topic, it's personal.
The space years.
It's a VR, oh, this is still VR.
Okay. Yeah. Ugh, that was gross. I think the biggest thing that VR needs to focus on is Farpoint. I've not heard of that before. I think the biggest thing that VR needs is if you're like in a situation where like if you wear glasses and you get like shit on them, like your vision's kind of blurred in one section. I think VR needs that, like a dust mechanic or something. Otherwise, it doesn't seem as real. Oh, Battlefield. Battlefront. Wait, which one's the Star Wars one?
Battlefront. Star Wars. Okay. Battlefront VR.
No, this has got to be like TIE Fighter.
I'd be down.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, let's go.
That was one of the coolest arcade cabinets. Oh, Battlefront. Okay, full on.
It's just VR support.
X-Wing VR mission.
Oh, that's bullshit. I don't want to play Battlefront.
Don't you have Battlefront already?
No.
Oh.
I never bought Battlefront. I'm voting with my wallet. I don't support EA and their shenanigans anymore.
I can't stand EA. EA has not released a game outside of Grow Home that I've, like, actually wanted to purchase.
Mass Effect 3 was fun. And 2.
How long ago was that?
A while ago. I'm saying. Hold on.
This has got to be Arkham.
Arkham Collection? Arkham VR? Batman VR?
No, that's Mark Hamill doing the Joker.
Yeah, yeah. So it's the Arkham Collection.
Or is it the Telltale one?
Oh, Telltale Batman? VR?
No, it's not Telltale, because this is still VR.
Dude, Telltale Batman's hype, though.
Yeah. Troy Baker. He's doing a Batman.
Collection. Oh my god.
So it doesn't have a full title yet?
Batman Arkham VR? So is it... What if...
October.
16.
Exclusively on PlayStation VR. Did the Resident Evil thing say exclusively PSVR? Because RE7 is not a console stuff. Oh shit.
What was the thing? Oh shit. Featuring Afrojack! That's pretty hype. Chocobo running?
Chocobo!
What was just announced right before this?
Batman VR.
Oh yeah.
It just said October 2016. Oh shit! That was rad.
Dude, the summons are gonna be real. Who's that? Is that the villain? What is Final Fantasy 15? Is it gonna be good?
Yeah. Yo. VR?
Final Fantasy 15 VR?
Evidently.
Oh.
Yeah.
It's probably
oh,
not.
Okay. Confirmed.
Confirmed.
See, I'm not gonna lie. That that seems like unnecessary.
It is.
Just as VR experience, does that mean the whole game is playable? I doubt it. Play as Prompto.
What does that mean?
One of the characters.
Oh. Who's doing VR experience or showing off? How do you do 15 early movements?
XV.
Good call. Yeah, I used to know Roman numerals so well, now I forget them. What is this?
No Man's Sky?
Oh, MVR.
No, I'm guessing. No, no, this is not.
No Man's Sky VR, that would be hype.
It is VR.
It is?
Yes.
Oh, I thought they didn't announce it yet. I mean, I think they're going to show a thing there. Oh, so many games. Too many games, dude. These are all gonna be $60 too.
Yeah. Gotta get a job or work. Oh, at school.
We've got 4 new hotspots on radar, sir.
Check.
A plotted course on your orders, sir.
What is this?
Stand by for objective. We've got a set depth destroyer in lunar orbit. We'll coordinate a takedown with Tigris.
The ship reminded me of FTL's ship, but like in 3D. And like FTL VR would be possibly the most terrifying.
FTL VR?
Would be the most terrifying thing in the universe.
What is, oh, Titanfall 2?
I don't know.
Is Titanfall 2 VR? Oh, that'd be cool. Robot fighting? This, I think this is Titanfall 2.
No, I thought Titanfall was Xbox exclusive.
No, it's gonna be, it's, they're switching it up now.
Okay.
It's gonna be on everything.
Thanks, AT.
I remember playing Titanfall once with Xander and Nick.
Yeah.
And just getting my ass handed to me. Hello, Vanessa.
Roger, we're lit.
How is the cheese today? What the fuck is this?
On my way, hang in there.
I got this. Open the way. No joy, no joy.
Easy, soul, easy.
Okay, box in, Raiders.
Look at this dogfight.
What is it for?
I don't know. But like, this is an incredible looking dogfight. Oh, Vanessa 345 is here.
Oh,
she cheese pulls. Oh shit.
What?
That looked like the thing from.
Is this gonna be Call of Duty?
You know? If. I don't think so. Like at all. Jesus!
You sure it's not gonna be Call of Duty?
It doesn't look like it.
It's not Titanfall, but I do know Titanfall is gonna be on PS4. Oh my god. Halo 6 confirm arena.
Really? I didn't.
No, I'm just kidding. I would not care about that either.
I didn't watch the Xbox conference because I frankly don't care about Xbox.
Yeah, same. Holy shit.
Dude,
I did the grapple, but like.
What was the game that had the grapple?
It's on VR, too.
Far Cry?
Just Cause.
Just Cause.
Yeah. Nice.
Yeah, we're watching E3. Wait, what did I do?
Force in, let's go.
Staff Sergeant, cover the exit. Ethan, restore life.
Don't do that.
Salt, scope the windows, I get the CO's card.
Yeah, we're watching the Sony conference right now. Like, to be honest, the Sony conference and the Nintendo conference are the only two things I'm interested in.
Mm-hmm.
So tomorrow at noon, we're going to be kicking this up again with Nintendo.
Oh, is that on the noon?
Noon Eastern Standard Time.
Nice. That was
shit,
cool.
That was a badass shield.
I do like that shield. This looks like...
Something I don't
this
know.
I don't like the art style necessarily. I don't know why.
It reminds me of Dead Space.
Yeah. Yeah.
Dead Space with EA. That's a game I like from EA.
There you go.
But how long ago was that?
2008.
Okay, so almost 10 years.
I think the original was 2008. I may be wrong. Playing E3 2016.
Oh, wait. Can I just put that in?
Yeah. Oh, I can change it.
I got it. I have it
down. Oh, it's Infinite Warfare 2. Yeah. Star Trek? Vanessa, you're trolling. I thought it was Call of Duty as well. Now you're saying Star Trek. What is that? It's definitely not Star Trek.
The dogfight looked really fucking cool.
Dude, I'm saying, alright, let's take a bet. I will just pound this entire vanilla Pepsi Coke. That made zero sense. I will pound this entire Pepsi if it's not a Call of Duty game. This is.
What do I do if I lose? Like, I'm not.
Kill yourself.
I don't doubt that this might be a Call of Duty game. I just don't know what yet.
I thought Infinite Warfare wasn't out yet. Apparently it is. That's how little I care about Call of Duty at this point. Yo, Battlefield 1 is hyped there. The World War 1 one?
Didn't say it.
Trench Warfare. I mean, like, space battles are awesome. What the fuck?
See, the dogfight looked really cool, but, like, the actual, like, shooting is not my speed.
Infinite Warfare, Infinite Warfare 2.
Infinite Warfare.
Call of Duty, Infinite Warfare 2, Star Trek, Chocobo, Harry, Force Awakens. I think it's called Chewbacca.
Oh, Chewbacca.
It's not Infinite Warfare 2, because I know that Infinite Warfare hasn't
even come out. It's C-H-E-W-B-A-C-C-A. Tom Clancy.
Dude. If this is what I think it is.
I'm just waiting to see, like, Splinter
Cell. Is this a remake of Modern Warfare 1?
Ugh.
No, I'm so in for that. Are you kidding? Fucking god, that's what it is. It's a modern. Oh my god, I'm gonna buy that. I'm gonna buy the shit out of it.
Why? I really don't give a shit about Modern Warfare or Call of Duty for that matter. I like the first one and I like Big Red 1. But that was because it was like.
Big Red One's awesome.
It's a remaster.
Wow! Oh my god.
Okay. Cool, I guess.
I'm in for that. That's when I cared about those.
You barely noticed. Yeah, no.
Oh god. Dude, when there was one year Sony came out and they just drew a bunch of stuff. Crash Bandicoot?
Hell yeah! Look at the shadow, that's so cool.
Crash Bandicoot Confirm Arena on VR?
That would make actually a really good VR game.
Yeah, that's right.
Where you been? I don't pay attention to Call of Duty games, honestly. I'm very big in the indie scene. And like the Nintendo scene.
Yeah, we don't follow Call of Duty at all, so. True. But I'm pretty hyped about Modern Warfare 1 remake.
We're going to bring back the original Crash, Crash 2, and Crash Warped. Fully remastered from the ground up for PlayStation 4.
Yes.
Long live the mascot platformer.
I believe it.
I don't care about this at all.
The Spyro series has actually been pretty interesting. I can't get into the buying toys to play a game thing. Like, I like the concept of amiibo, but I don't want to actually purchase an amiibo. Thanks, by the way. Check it.
Is this Crash? Oh, it's Skylanders.
I love that look.
It's the Skylanders Crash thing.
I love that look.
I don't like Skylanders.
Nah.
just don't care about skill games. Mm-hmm. It's a kid's game. Still play kids games.
Yeah, no, that's... It's not
that... I don't want to use kids games as a, like, a
derogatory term.
Yeah. But I just don't... You have to... It's also the toys to life. So you have to invest in the toys to life. That sounds...
What?
That sounds Spore. It's just Spore.
Oh, that's... I didn't like Spore.
I don't want to compare it to Spore. It's not Spore. It does remind me of Spore.
Oh, that's cool.
How many DLCs is
I can dig that. I can dig that. Another Star Wars game? Oh, Lego Star Wars.
I see your eyes.
Lego Star Wars?
Dude, I know it's been out for a while, but when they released the trailer for Star Wars Force Awakens, that was one of the best trailers in modern history, and in recent history.
Mez Kanata's voice.
Yes?
Mez Kanata was played by this one Stetson kid's sister.
Peter Nyong'o.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mez Kanata?
Mez Kanata. The lady with the glasses.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I know what you're talking about.
What was done right after Call of Duty, but before this?
Modern Warfare.
It was a really hype release right
Crash
after.
Bandicoot.
Oh, yeah.
Dude.
Hey, I'm focused on the now. I'm trying to... Look at the Kylo bot.
This droid has to get to the resistance base as soon as possible.
He's carrying a man to Luke Skywalker. Don't tell me your breath there's got loose. I got a bad feeling about this.
See, I've never had a bad experience with a Lego game.
It was first, second, and Warps.
Yeah. And then Skylanders.
I don't care as a about playable.
It's still the news.
I get to reward what I want, though. That's the best part about it. Hashtag corruption.
We're not done yet.
Why are Lego games so awesome? They've just been consistently releasing, like, really.
Yeah, I don't know. I think it's because they care.
They put a lot of effort into them.
They really do.
I never play them, but they're always a good game.
I think I still own, like, Lego Island, too.
They have the twisty guy.
Yeah. Traitor.
Emperor Snoke is an asshole.
Yeah.
I'm excited to learn more about him, though.
Download the demo, available now. Right now. Go fucking figure. Oh shit. Nice.
I like all these demos coming out though. What was the one demo that we have to download?
RE5? RE7?
Yeah.
Yeah. Bum, 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 bum. God, I love that fanfare.
It was Skylanders Imagineers.
Yeah.
Andy House.
Make PlayStation the best place to play for gamers. And I think you'll agree that this marks one of the
Imaginators. Imaginators. My bad.
That's a result of our commitment to partnerships with the most talented developers and storytellers in our media. And as proof of that commitment, please join me in welcoming one of the most creative talents in the history of
gaming. What was the name of that piece? I can't remember. Bum, 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 bum. Bum, 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 bum.
What? Hideo? Kojima's in the house? Is it?
Yes!
I couldn't see his face. Kojima's in the house!
Dude, they were showing the logo.
Oh, I didn't see it.
They're like, going logo? Yeah. That's, oh, shit. Dude, did you see it? You have to go. You have to look at the art.
Kojima's in the house?
Kojima's in the house. Just write that sentence. Kojima in house. That's all you need to know.
Hello? Hello, everyone. I'm back.
It's
Fuck
him. Konami finally released him from his jail.
He's free.
Sony freed him.
Hashtag free Kojima.
Dude. All running in real time. Oh shit, this is gonna be fucking gold. Oh, I'm so excited.
What could it be? What are they gonna be working on? It's gonna be like 2018 release.
That's fine.
Dude.
This looks fucking gorgeous.
Crabs. Kojima Productions. PS4 exclusive.
Better oh, absolutely.
Hop on board, motherfucker.
I've already said I'm going to buy one.
Oh my god. What? It's quiet DLC. Who that?
Free coach.
Free coach. What the fuck?
That is a
robot baby
infant,
dude,
and a very naked man.
What the fuck is happening?
Why is he prints all over him though?
Was Lego Star Wars a gameplay or just trailer?
Trailer.
Walking Dead? That looks like
that's
a Walking
Norman
Dead.
Reedus. Oh, he's working with them. Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
That's
yep.
So weird. It was gameplay.
Norman Reedus. No, Lego Star Wars was trailer. Demo's out though. Happening.
Fucking god, Kojima. Kojima's on!
I would love to see a movie by Kojima.
That'd be awesome. That's what this is, basically.
No, but like, I feel. Oh, what the hell?
I have no idea what's happening.
Nope.
Those Norman, what is this game? Oh, I'm gonna be so upset because they're gonna cut it off in like 3 seconds.
Yeah.
But that's all we're gonna get. What?
I love the typeset. Norman Reedus in. I want to go to the Black Sand Beach. Death Stranding.
Death Stranding?
Interesting.
Terrible title.
I disagree. I want to go to the Black Sand Beaches in Iceland, which I'm pretty sure that's what that was based off of. Oh, shit. I'm so excited.
Death Stranding. What's that? Norman Reedus, right?
Yeah. And R-E-D-U-S.
It's not really me you're seeing.
Insomniac. It's Jack.
Probably for the best.
That sounds like Jack.
No.
Everything hinges on a guy from Queens. Sounds as scary as it feels.
Spider-Man! Spider-Man confirmed! Spider-Man confirmed! Fucking go! No pressure, right? It's a Spider-Man Insomniac game. I thought Sucker Punch was gonna make it.
I don't know. Look at that.
Dude. I thought Sucker Punch was gonna make it because they make the Infamous games.
Yeah, yeah.
That's what the theory was, but.
Dude, look at that.
I like that suit, logo. That suit is badass, too.
Yeah.
Oh my fucking god. Spider-Man's in the house.
Whose voice was that?
I don't know. The guy from the movie?
No.
I can't believe Insomniac's making it.
Wow. This looks so great. I'm calling it now. Sony won.
Spider-Man PS4. Yeah, dude, of course they did. I don't care. We don't know about Nintendo.
It always boils
NX
down.
NX release.
No, it always boils down to Sony versus Nintendo, in my opinion, and Nintendo's doing very little. God, I fucking love this music. Oh my god.
There wasn't a release date for Stranded, right?
No, not even close.
Yeah, it's gonna be 2018. I don't know why they would have released it, but...
Kojima in the house!
Everyone, sometime in your life, you have the ability to walk on limbs. It's the most amazing thing ever, let me tell you.
He is very accurate.
Tim, take it out. We are on the verge of a future unlike any other. Thanks to the dedication and the passion of the greatest gaming community around. We are committed to delivering the future technologies and experiences that will continue to evolve constantly. We thank you, our partners, our allies, our friends.
I think that's it.
For going along with us on this journey.
I remember PS4 controller. What?
Somebody just goes, thank you.
At the core of interactive entertainment is the concept of play. The rest of us have to talk about stories and visuals and emotions and graphics and technology. It all comes together in the brilliance of gameplay. So before I leave, it is my distinct pleasure to share
Insomniac for your battery.
Demo
yeah.
With all of you, of a title we introduced earlier tonight, where we'll see it played live. Thank you for coming out, ladies and gentlemen. Days gone.
Days gone. So this is at the start.
Yeah.
Did you say Last of Us 2 earlier?
Yeah.
Is that actually a thing?
They're talking about it, but it wouldn't be Joel and Ellie. It'd be like different people.
Like during the same
time. Yeah, because there's a bunch of other stories to tell.
See, I could see.
But
like,
but there's not. Uncharted 4 just came out, so there's
yeah.
no way that you
no,
know
no, no,
they're
no.
doing.
I could see like kind of like how Star Wars is doing it now, like Rogue One, a Star Wars story. I could see like.
I like that.
A
yeah.
title, a Last of Us game.
Dude, Vanessa's really on top of her cod shit. She's getting chewed at me. MW1 remake. Where have you been?
Not paying attention to Call of Duty. You didn't realize that? Yeah.
You're the best.
I started working on one for Nintendo tomorrow, but I stopped because I went to Best Buy to buy a fan.
I stopped working time when Kojima was in the house.
Wolves. Yeah. Dude. Yeah. You know they flew him in for that, like, 15 seconds, and they paid him, like, $4 million. Kojima is the Marlon Brando of the video game world. They'll give him any amount of money he asks for because he is who he is.
That's true.
Oh shit, silencer.
Get that one. Spider-Man for PS4.
I don't like the color scheme of this.
Yo, that's Spider. It's kind of too brown for me.
I mean, it suits the environment. Like, it suits the world, because it's. It seems like.
Oh shit.
That was a child.
Yeah, it was a dead child.
It seems like autumn in a dying world.
Dead
but,
baby.
And it's the golden hour, so everything should look. Kind of sun-kissed, you know?
I just want to be one of the live demo people and then fuck up.
Oh god, yes.
Holy shit. Why would you not aim at that little demon baby?
Ooh. Did not like that. Did not like that one bit.
The shooting the baby?
Yeah, no. No, not, okay. Not particularly.
I like this convenient pallet placement to get up on the roof. Look at those. This is the year of the draw distance, dude. I'm telling you. Look around, dude, Kojima's in the house. Kojima's so fucking hype. Oh, shit.
Oh, it's just another fucking zombie game.
Yeah. I don't need more of this. This looks just like Last of Us.
I'm so sick of the zombie genre.
I need to take a break from it for sure.
I'm so sick of the supernatural genre, honestly. Like, I can honestly go another, like, 10 years without seeing a zombie film or just anything about, like, vampires or witches.
I was excited for this, and now I'm not. Because I thought it was going to be humans and not beasts. I always like the human struggle a bit the more. Like in The Road, you know, it's a human struggle.
Yeah.
It's like eating each other. Holy
jeez,
fuck.
Okay, that's enough.
Never mind. That's so high.
That just looks so stupid.
What? That was awesome. They're piling out.
It looks like they like had like a spawn point generator.
Yeah.
And they like cranked up the number too much. Or like one of those like physics simulators where it's like, what would it look like if you dropped 30 bodies off of this thing?
Boom. Do you remember the 500 Death Claws versus 300 Brothers of Steel?
Didn't it, like, destroy the computer it was on?
No, it was really strong, so... Last
I remember they did one simulation where like, it was, like, simulating at, like, 12 frames per second, but then it got faster and faster and faster as, like, more and more just died.
Oh my god, there's...
Okay, this isn't necessary.
Yeah, this is just... You should just be running. You shouldn't be shooting. The horde is
this
real.
This looks so bad.
Yeah, look at the bullet spray. Why do they choose to focus on this? I mean, it's still cool, but like...
One, he should be out of bullets by now.
That's true. What was I going to say now? I don't know why they choose to give this such a spotlight. They should have given it to fucking Kojima or something.
Yeah, well...
More Kojima time.
I doubt that he has gotten much prepared.
He should have just talked about everything.
Well, no, because Kojima Productions, they've only been
they've
working
only been
together
a thing since, for like a few months.
6 months, five
yeah.
months?
I didn't want them to show any more games, I just meant him just talking.
I just wanted Kojima to
talk more.
I follow his Twitter, and he's just like, oh, I watched a movie tonight, it was pretty good. I'm like, yes, please tell me more about
I'm so fascinated by that.
Holy shit. I forgot what he watched recently, but it was like not a good movie.
This looks like it could be on PS3.
Yeah.
Except for the draw distance and everything. I like the live orchestra, though.
Yeah, the live orchestra's killing it. To anyone and everyone who is in the art community, keep on keeping on. Oh, come on.
Is he actually going to kite them all down? That'd be hella impressive.
How many fucking magazines does he have?
He's grinding. He got them all.
Wait, he's going to turn around. And there's going to be more!
This game looks utterly unappealing.
I would have never guessed.
Come on! Come on!
Okay. They lost me.
Yeah, they lost me on that game for sure.
It looked like it to be all, like, bikers and stuff.
Yeah, I thought it was going to be, like, you know, really sad, like, biker shit. Like, him just riding alone, taking out dudes on the road. Back to Kojima?
I think they're just doing like a recap.
Oh, cool.
So, Detroit... Oh, wait. Did they just show an Attack on Titan game?
What?
I just saw like an Attack on Titan like thing.
Yo, the
oh,
best thing...
this is just like...
The best thing ever, Greg's thing. The word Vita gets mentioned no more than 3 times. Hasn't been mentioned once.
They were talking.
What was that?
This was from the pre-show. They were showing trailers.
Persona 5? Dude, Persona 5 is so fucking bad.
So in the pre-show, they were showing trailers, and I'm pretty sure two or three of the games were for Vita. I don't know if they're Vita exclusives.
Looks like the Ghostbusters game came out. Deus Ex. Mankind United.
Morpheus. See, I think they should stick to like keeping things named like really cool, like Morpheus. As opposed to just, like, PlayStation VR. I mean, it's straightforward and to the point, but, like, calling it a Morpheus is just way more cool. Oh, yeah, they showed the South Park trailer.
Street Fighter.
At Ubisoft.
It was a pretty good conference.
Yeah.
I wish they didn't spend so much time on the William at the end there, but...
No.
It'd be a great VR highlight, though. The only one I wish they didn't show was that
they
one.
Also didn't, if I,
they had a really long Call of Duty thing.
They didn't show a release date for Days Gone, so I don't know why they focus on it so much.
No, yeah. But Sony Ben had been like under the radar for so long, so.
Is that that? God of War, Days Gone, Horizon Zero. Horizon Zero Dawn looked good. Detroit Becoming Human, Spider-Man. All looked great. Death Stranding is going to be great because it's fucking Kojima.
Mm-hmm.
So, certainly four games I'm looking forward to. I like the idea of a Crash remake. It's not a console seller to me. And it's not something I would necessarily buy right off the bat. Oh, they're so awkward. Take your time. Oh, that's painful.
Meredith, I dreamt there was a new God of War. Meredith, I dreamt that Ben Studio was working on a biker zombie apocalypse game.
There was so much good stuff, I don't even know where to start.
Meredith, I dreamt that Insomniac was making a new Spider-Man, and I dreamt that Kojima was here, and Norman Reedus was here.
Who is she?
I don't know.
VR Batman.
VR Batman type.
The VR stuff looked really cool.
Spider-Man one was awesome.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a console seller to me, but it's not. I'm sorry. It's a VR seller to me, but not a console seller. So like, if I had a PS4, I would definitely buy the VR for RE7. Let's just go through the recap real quick and see what.
All right, ready?
So,
you want to turn this down a little bit?
It's not picking up.
I just want to talk for thinking, for my sanity. Oh, yeah, they didn't even talk about the God of War thing. That was a great intro. All right, so it opens with. So let's just go through and talk about if we're God excited for them or not.
Oh,
God of War, name unknown. It was just God of War, right? For now.
No, it's just God of War.
That's so weird.
Looks good. Not a series I have any attachment to.
Looks a lot better. It looks interesting camera angle and stuff. Like looked more like
more
a
cinematic. More
looked more like a cinematic third person action game than yeah. a.
I don't want to say that God of War isn't the PS3 version.
I don't want to say that God of War isn't cinematic because God of War focuses on the whole like you're climbing yeah. the whole thing. Yeah.
I would definitely okay. So let's see. All right, God of War is not a seller to me. It's something I would definitely play. But I'm very sure I would wait for it to be on sale.
I can agree.
I don't have any attachment to the series and all that jazz.
Right.
Days Gone really lost me.
So like, Sony Ben has been underground for a while, and then they come out and announce this zombie. Yeah, so I had Mountain Field Landscape.
It looks like every other zombie game I've ever seen.
I just don't know what else there's to say about Sony Ben.
See,
so.
It looks like every zombie game I've ever seen, but it doesn't have like a gimmick. Like it didn't have.
I don't think it'll sell well.
No.
We'll see though. And there was no a release date announced for it. Can you vamp for a second?
Yeah. Let me see that list. I'm just gonna go through real quick.
No, Aaron, just wait. Go through together. You gotta vamp.
All right. Well. I'm going to talk about what I was excited about. Personally, I was more excited for the Spider-Man game and the Resident Evil 7 game because I am a massive, massive fan of Resident Evil. And I think that just the whole world that they've built around just a simple concept of everything's gone to shit has been incredibly interesting. I like the fact that they didn't show any gunplay in it, and I think that was very telling of what the series has become and what it should go back to. Other than that, I can't really say much until he gets back because he's a piece of shit and blah 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 blah. So how are you? How have you been? Did you like the show? I like the show. Do you think Sony won? Is it too early to call? Do you think Nintendo's gonna show them up? The last time Nintendo won was when they announced Smash. And that just fucking stole the show because it's a Smash Brothers game. This year, I know they're talking about the new Legend of Zelda Wii U game, which I think is a mistake to release on the Wii U and the NX. like Twilight Princess was. But I don't know. The Nintendo show just doesn't seem too interesting to me. And it makes me really sad because I'm a lifelong Nintendo fan. My first system. All that. Oh, he's back.
Japan?
Yeah, I talked about Nintendo.
Well, that's not what we're talking about though.
Nope.
Alright, you ready to go through this list?
Let's go through this list. We just covered God of War.
Yeah.
God of War.
Is Vanessa still here?
Looks good. No.
Rip. Alright. Sonny Ben. Last Guardian trailer show with release date October 25th. Fucking finally.
Last Guardian is one of those games that... Nice. That has no preconceived notion of what it should be. Which is why I think it will absolutely live up to the hype. Because we don't know what kind of game it's supposed to be. Like, it's going to be like Ico and like Shadow of the Colossus. But each one of those improved upon itself. And there's no predetermined, like, platformer. There's no boss rush. There's no anything about it other than this is The Last Guardian. It's by Team Ico.
The Last Guardian, I'm quoting from the wiki, The Last Guardian has been in development since 2007, a year after the release of the PlayStation 3. So they have been going through that many delays. I wonder how much the gameplay has changed since then, or if it's just been overhauling the graphics, you know.
There's a really interesting concept that Team Ico implies, designed by subtraction, which I think works really well for their game. So they're going to build a game, and then they're going to take out all the parts of it until it gets to the point where they need it to be what it needs to be.
And frankly, I trust them with what they're going to do. I'm going to move that and bring it up.
Okay.
All right. Back.
Pardon the shitty lighting.
Next.
My room is not big enough for my lights. Really great. Lights.
You ready? Yeah. Oh, we have shitty lighting.
I mean,
it's the same lighting we've always had.
No, but it's like yellow as opposed to.
That's not good. Guerrilla Games brought on Horizon Zero Dawn's gameplay demo.
Horizon Zero Dawn, I said this when we were watching it, but it looks like...
That was a terrible sentence. Guerrilla Games brought on Horizon Zero Dawn.
It looks like it took the best parts of Far Cry and the best parts of like Skyrim and made a game out of it. What little we did see of it looked really promising, and I definitely trust the developers to release a game that's up to par with the hype that they're surrounding. Well, I keep saying hype.
It looked similar to like Far Cry, but with robot dinosaurs. Like, you're scrapping the parts and upgrading with the environment.
What I remember from Far Cry.
Which one did you play?
First one.
Oh, well, that's way different.
The first one's really good, though.
Yeah, it's way different. I'm saying it's more linear than the 3 and 4.
But
Primal.
I'm talking about like the actual gameplay of it, not this like the story of how to get around. The gameplay of Far Cry 1 stands out to me because it felt real. Like, it felt tense, and you felt dramatic and blah, blah, blah. And I think that this showed, like, you clearly had limits on what you had, the ammo you had, the type of things you could craft, and the type of things you could carry.
True.
Which I think is definitely going to add to the world of the game. Because the world of the game looks primitive, for lack of a better term.
Supposed to.
No, I agree. Yeah. Like, it has that futuristic vibe, obviously, with the robots and stuff, but it still looks like people are primitive, or people have lost, like, their way with technology. So, like, are you playing someone who is a mastermind of crafting and of war, or are you playing just a person who has to figure it out as they go along?
Right.
And I think it's the latter.
Through Russian Portuguese.
That's okay. I think it's the latter, and because of that, you're going to have to learn the mechanics through trial and error. Mm. Much like Far Cry, the first Far Cry. But I also like the choice system, much like Skyrim, much like...
The dialogue choice.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a Mass Effect thing as well. The dialogue wheel.
Yeah, the Bethesda good Fallouts.
Right.
My hatred for Fallout 4 knows
what do you think about the swapping weapons on the fly?
That was really interesting to me.
I like that, because it keeps the gameplay flowing.
I liked the fact that it slowed down time as opposed to stopping completely like Bioshock does. So it added to the tension of the fight.
And then remember, she made the traps in Lifetime as well.
Correct, yeah.
That was pretty cool.
But the traps in Lifetime, if I remember Like, crafting the traps...
Was it on the menu?
Crafting and traps were on a menu, but like to lay down the traps was live.
Oh, okay, okay.
So, I don't know if, like, going to that menu stops gameplay entirely, or... What? I don't know. We'll figure that out.
Detroit Become Human was announced.
That looks fascinating.
So, it's gonna be... I have written down, like, it's gonna play, because in the demo, the only gameplay we saw was just, like, Heavy Rain, where it's, like... A scene is happening, and then, like, a dialogue bar will appear, and you have to choose which one you want.
There were certain parts...
Or be, like, kill or not kill, you know, that's what happened in Heavy Rain.
There were certain parts...
Jason!
That very much like a Telltale game, where you have a couple options to choose from.
Right.
But there are certain parts in the thing that looked just be specifically dialogue, not the actual gameplay.
Okay.
So it looked like a dialogue tree that you could choose, but there actually seemed to be a decent amount of gameplay in it, where there was a shooting mechanic, there was they slowed down time for something to, like, emphasize something, and I couldn't tell if that was gameplay or if it was just, like, the video.
Right.
But there was definitely more input than a usual Telltale game or, like, Heavy Rain.
It looks more gamey than, I want to bring up it seems to be centered around the idea of, like, an android escaping, so the plot seems really cool.
Oh, yeah. I'm a very, very interested in robotics, and I love the concept of the laws of robotics and blah, blah, blah. And
robots.
The idea of artificial intelligence gaining sentience is utterly fascinating to me.
Definitely.
And to be able to play as a robot...
Same thing with Sorry.
To play as an android who's either learning sentience, has sentience, or what have you... just seems like a great concept.
Okay. So, I wanted to bring up Deus Ex as well. Like, they didn't show anything, but it's going to come out.
I saw the little clips of it. I did not play any of the Deus Ex series, so I should not comment on it.
Oh, really? It's going to be... I just meant as far as, like, Android stuff.
Okay.
Like, augmentation. Is it okay? Those sorts of questions.
What do you mean? Like, ethically?
Yeah, that's what the whole point of Deus Ex is about. It's like... like, the really, really old one on PC I played, and then I played the newest one on consoles.
I really don't know.
But they're all about that sort of the ethics of augmentation.
See, so. I think augmentation
and looks
for
like...
medical purposes is ethical. I think augmentation in a plastic surgery sense...
No, but this isn't medical, this is like...
Warfare.
Warfare, yeah.
Yeah, no, I think augmentation for the purposes outside of medical are unnecessary. Because I honestly, I can't see a person... Like, I make a joke about it all the time, like, but I would love robot hands, but, like, in the sense...
I would love robot hands.
I would love robot hands in, like, the sense of, like, a Mega Man or an Iron Man hand, but I would have zero purpose for repulsor blasts and to shoot lemons. Like, that does not benefit me at all. Interesting, yes. Beneficial, not at all.
Okay... Then they did their PSVR stuff at 9:37. They started it, and the first trailer was their RE7 VR announcement.
The demo
is out tonight.
Yeah, I said this earlier. RE7 is a VR seller to me. It is not a console seller. When I inevitably own a PS4, because I'm definitely getting Last Guardian, I'm definitely getting Kingdom Hearts 3, I'm definitely getting 15, I'm definitely getting RE7.
Mm-hmm.
When I buy RE7, I'm probably going to buy VR alongside it.
Mm.
Provided I have a job.
And $400, yeah.
Oh, God, that's going to...
Yeah, that was definitely a good trailer.
I swear to God, if that game's, like, bad, and I just drop $470...
There's a bunch of other stuff in VR that'd be worth it.
Yeah.
And let's get into that, including PSVR
I want to talk about RE7.
Let's go on RE7. But I want to bring up...
I want to talk about
RE5 made me salty. RE6 was also not that good. They tried to do Return to Form with RE6, but it wasn't
RE6
well received.
Had really good parts, and I think what they tried to do... I think what they tried to do with RE6 was good. I really do. I think because some people enjoy the action elements of RE5. Granted, that's a minority of people who play the RE series. But the fact that you could choose between the action side, the stealth side, the survival side, whatever you want to call it, was a really good implementation of their mechanics in that world. I personally played RE6. I did not beat it because I did not care for the action sequences, and the story didn't carry it enough for me to go through it. But if you look at the story of the original Resident Evil and you look at the story of Resident Evil 2, they're not good. Like, they're not really compelling stories. But, like, Resident Evil 2 really made you feel helpless and really made you feel like you were being attacked by zombies. And Resident Evil 4, I didn't play 3. I also haven't really heard good things about 3, but I haven't played it to comment. Resident Evil 4, I think, was the best example of it because of the accessibility to the game. The whole adaptive difficulty system. But also at the same time, it had a great story. It had beautifully implemented mechanics that made you feel... It made you feel like a special ops agent, but it also made you feel like a human at the same time. Like, you're not this, like... You're not Master Chief, this hyper-intense super soldier. You still felt human, you still felt vulnerable, but you definitely felt like someone who has special ops training.
True.
Resident Evil 5 focused way too much on shooting galleries, as opposed to...
It was just an action game.
Yeah, it wasn't bad, it wasn't good. It was that awkward in-between... and RE6 had elements of both, but
RE6 was trying to go back to 4, but it just failed. It was still fun.
The Leon Kennedy sections definitely went back to RE4,
right.
But it was so short.
Right.
It didn't justify the $60.
Who were the other parts?
Chris.
Chris parts were lame.
Jill.
Probably. No, was it wasn't Jill. The other lady. No.
I don't know.
Can't think about that. But
it's been
so,
2 or 3 years.
What I want to talk about is the the gameplay shift, because on 4. You kill, like, not that many enemies, and you have not that many bullets, and it gives that feeling of scarcity. And then 5 was just, bro, shoot the Nemesis type T, and you have a million bullets.
See, to be fair, I played on the harder difficulty setting because I wanted that survival aspect of it, but it really just turned the enemies into bullet sponges more so than you're limited on resources, which I think adds to the Resident Evil thing. But what I liked most about this trailer and this reveal... was I did not see any semblance of weapons. To me, it looked like you were playing like a detective or something. Like, well, I mean, you should be. But it looked like you were playing a more grounded character than
Special
a Stars
Ops,
agent.
Leon Kennedy.
A Stars agent. I really like the fact that there were no weapons shown. I think that's going to add to the stealth survival element of it. Like, if it's kept.
That's what they need to get back to, is my point. Mm-hmm. Is that they need to return back
and
to that feeling of scarcity.
I think that the VR is going to carry... I'm not going to say it's going to carry it. I think the VR is going to add so much to a game like that that you will not see Resident Evil 8, 9, 10, however many there are, that aren't offered on VR.
Sure. Yeah, I agree with you.
Mm-hmm.
The VR implementation is going to be really
high. I'm so excited for that.
I'm probably not going to play it on VR, though, just because I'm a big baby.
That's fair. Yeah. No, like, if you don't like horror games, you don't like horror games.
Well, I like playing Resident Evil games, so I just play them with the controller, because that's too immersive for me. I'm not going to touch any VR horror games.
I really don't know much about the VR. Is the VR, like, kind of like the Vive controller, where it's the two handheld things, and then you kind of move with it? Or are you going to play
with
a PS4 controller?
I'm pretty sure you have a PS4 controller, but then you can also use the Move if you wanted to.
But I thought they were making, like, a new Move.
It's going to be a new Move, yeah. But, like, I'm just going to use a PS controller.
Okay, well, that's fair.
That works for me. The headset's enough.
If I'm in a VR thing, I don't really want... I kind of want to play like I played Skyward Sword. Like, I want to be standing up and kind of, like, not walking, but enough.
In your
I'm...
room, yeah. I mean, you can still stand up.
So. Yeah.
Okay, so the price and release date was announced.
Well. Price and release date, $3.99.
October 13th.
13th, okay.
And 50 games at launch with full VR support.
50 games... between launch and end of the year.
Okay.
So, in a 2-month period, there's going to be 50 games. The Battlefront VR experience looks fascinating. It looks like the TIE Fighter arcade game, but just cranked up to 10. So, that's going to be cool. That's going to be really cool.
Sorry, just give me 1 second. Talk about No Man's Sky.
They didn't show anything for No Man's Sky.
But where did you hear that it was VR? Because I haven't
Everywhere.
Heard that before.
Yeah. I don't know if it's PlayStation VR. I know it's VR, though. I know for certain it's going to be, like, PC VR. And I would be shocked if PlayStation didn't support VR for No Man's Sky. I think they're not talking about it as VR just because No Man's Sky is coming out August.
Right.
Yeah. And obviously PSVR is not going to be out.
That's true. So it'll be a later retro, not a retrograde, but a later feature added on to it.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, so 50 games in 2 months. Mm-hmm. That sounds pretty cool. That's a good library.
Oh, absolutely.
My thing was, like, if they didn't have the library to support it, it would be like the Wii U, where there was just no games and the peripheral wasn't supported.
Yeah.
I just don't want the peripheral to fail, because Vita was such a failure that if they have another peripheral fail, then it's just going to be PS4.
Yeah.
But I just really want to talk about the lack of Vita at the conference. They really just have abandoned Vita. And there's...
I enjoy owning mine, but there's... The pre-stuff had some... I don't want to say exclusive, but they had some Vita coverage a little bit. But Sony has never...
It was supposed to be a...
They've never been strong in the handheld market.
Right, but the whole thing was is that Vita was their chance, and then their marketing failed, and they in general just kind of been like, they failed just because the memory card issue, and
I think that there's a lot wrong with the Vita. I think
the lack of games that will release,
the lack of games at release, the memory card, the
proprietary card,
yeah, proprietary card. That's the word I'm looking for. But also, if I remember correctly, Vita was released around the time of the iPhone. And mobile gaming kind of dipped. And I don't want to say dipped. Mobile gaming really... Oh, way after.
No, hold on. These are the revised ones. Oh. I'm talking about the old ones.
Just go to the Wikipedia page, it'll be there.
Because the OLED one released before. That was the over-expensive one.
2012.
History.
It'll be on the right-hand side. 2011. So the iPhone... Okay, so the iPhone came out... 2007.
2011.
And then...
Yeah, with the advent of... I get what you're saying. With the advent of mobile gaming, there was less of a reason to have a handheld.
But
the 3DS broke that because the games were just so good.
And it was also cheap.
Yeah.
But...
It was like, what, 300 at release?
PS Vita?
No, I'm talking about the 3DS.
I want to say like 250. I got mine cheap. I got mine for like 180. Like... 250. Yeah.
And then drop down to one. Yeah. Huh. Interesting. Yeah, so it's an interesting marketplace because of the advent of mobile gaming, but I think there's still definitely a market for handheld, but it's definitely niche. It's niche, and Nintendo capitalized on it, so that's why...
I think Nintendo implemented it better just because...
They have handheld experience.
The DS.
Yeah, but I just meant that they have a handheld experience because the DS was such a killer.
But then console quality on the go, that was their like big selling point. And while it is an interesting thing, it jacks the price up so much.
Right, but the thing,
I think that the PS Vita was inaccessible. The savior
of the Vita is that these indie games and these obtuse Japanese games are all selling really well, really really well, and they're all really well made. Like some of these Vita games I've been playing recently have just been like phenomenal experiences.
Severed is great.
Yeah, Severed's fantastic, but like. It's just tough because what you see in the Vita is that there's a very high attach rate. Like a lot of people that have a Vita buy a bunch of games.
Oh yeah.
But nobody bought a Vita, so that's why the attach rate's so high. It's just a bad situation, and it's just evident that there wasn't a single game revealed for Vita.
I'm pretty sure Yooka-Laylee, the Banjo-Kazooie spiritual successor, is going to be on Vita. Like Yooka.
That's how you spell it?
Yeah. Yooka and then Lee. I think so. Or L-A-Y. Never mind.
Oh, they showed a thing at the end. I remember seeing that.
That was part of the pre-show. Oh, maybe not. Sorry. Their answer isn't surprising. Yeah.
Huh?
Their answer isn't surprising.
Uh-oh.
Maybe not. Anyway.
So we're going to Steve... I was saying if one of their goals would be Vita support, but it's not. Oh, here we go. Simultaneous Wii U, Xbox One, and PS4 releases on day one.
So £1 million. Yeah,
no Vita.
Bummer.
So, yeah.
But you have a PS4, so you can just do the cross-platform thing.
Gives us lots of compound effect.
It's just going to be Banjo-Kazooie, but with new characters. Cool.
Yeah, no, exactly.
It's going to be amazing, yeah. Okay, let's continue.
Back to what we're talking about. VR.
Okay.
We talked about RE7. About
so demo's out now,
demo's
but
out
it's
now.
Not VR supported.
No.
Because there's no VR.
So yes.
Farpoint, the first-person space shooter, looks okay. I don't know. It wasn't like a... It didn't stand out to me.
No.
That was just the one where he was on like Mars and then shooting. Yeah. And then...
Unfortunately forgettable.
Yeah. Then they showed the Battlefront like space combat one.
See, the Battlefront, if I understand this correctly, it's DLC.
Yeah, it's DLC for Battlefront.
So
I'm not going to get it, but...
Well, how much is the DLC going to be? Like, $20?
I don't know. I don't know how much the standalone is. Because the season pass is like 40 or 50 or 60. I'm not sure.
Which isn't bad, because you have a lot of DLC for Battlefront.
There's none yet. There's only been one for the entire release.
But they have scheduled.
Yeah, it's still disappointing.
I think the support for Battlefront is there, and I think that the interest for Battlefront is there, and especially with the VR.
It's sold a fuck ton. It's just
going to be through the roof.
Yeah. A strange trailer featuring no gameplay surface for Batman Arkham VR. It was just a October 2016 release. There was no gameplay or anything, so we don't really
know.
What
the hell
it was just Mark Hamill laughing.
Yeah.
It looks pretty hype. I just, like, I can't say anything about it because there's just nothing.
Because there's no way it can be just a first-person version of Arkham, because that would make so many people sick, especially with, like, the ridiculous fighting mechanic. I hate that so much. I really don't like the Arkham series for that reason.
Right. Okay, then we have... Final Fantasy XV VR experience, but it appears to be a small part of the true Final Fantasy XV. Gameplay was shown off in first person,
which
he was walking around
yeah.
shooting, and then there was a dude with a sword, I believe. But
yeah.
Like, so it looks cool, but I feel like it's not going to be, it's only going to be like a few hours.
Yeah.
Like, if you buy Final Fantasy XV, you
see,
get that.
They showed,
it's like a so
they showed gameplay from Final Fantasy XV that wasn't the VR initially, which,
right.
again, increased
the excitement.
Do you
know about the VR experiences, though?
Not really.
Have you heard about them? Okay,
no.
So there's, it's going to be... So there's 50 launch games,
yeah,
but they're
yeah.
not all going to be $60 games.
No.
These experiences
yeah,
are
going
to be like the PS Minis back in the day, where it's like a $5 game.
Right.
And so like,
kind of like what they're doing with like Vive and Oculus now. They have some free games, they have some full price games, they have some lower cost games, to appeal to each demographic. So like the VR experiences are going to be lower in price, but equally as good. Or equally as complete, I should say.
Well, yeah, they're just shorter things. It's
yeah,
like
yeah.
going to be a few hours instead of being a full game, full retail release. So, yeah, so that's what the Final Fantasy XV one appears to be. Then the Infinite Warfare gameplay was shown. Does anyone actually care?
The dog fight looked fantastic.
That was a cool
that,
scene, yeah.
That like really drew me in.
I did like the grappling hook in space, but like it didn't... it's still... The whole time I was like, is this a Call of Duty game? Because it looks so much like
I would
a Call
be
Duty
interested
game.
In playing it. For the dog fighting, but this is like God of War. I can't justify spending $60 on a full release to play like two sections.
That's true.
That is something I would potentially buy off sale, but I haven't bought a Call of Duty game since Big Red 1, which was PS2.
And then Call of Duty Modern Warfare 1 remaster campaign.
No interest.
Anything. I'm interested in the multiplayer, just to kind of relive that, because that was a very important part of my gaming career. But I'm more excited for the remake, for the remaster of Modern Warfare than the Infinite one. But
That's fair.
Crash Bandicoot is in the house. They're remaking the first, second, and Warped games. I don't remember playing Warped, but I remember 1 and 2.
Warped was really... Well...
I'm just glad they're
see,
not making
the
Wrath
of Cortex.
The
first three Crash games, from my memory...
What was the one that Pedal played? Twisted?
Yeah, I think so.
Oh, what's it called?
Yeah, yeah. It was like the worst one
twin,
of all time.
Twin something.
Twin Sanity?
Twin Sanity. Yeah, it was Twin Sanity.
Definitely that one.
Were they attached or whatever?
Yeah. Ugh. All right, well.
But yeah, Crash remakes. So.
Crash looked really cool.
That's hype. I'm interested to see
and I
where
how they did,
I'm interested
like the
to see where the mascot platformer genre goes, because they're trying to like revitalize it. A lot of the thing was that what people were saying is that Ratchet and Clank was going to be the only one out of that genre to come back, but now
no,
that Crash is
no.
but now that's what well, I mean besides Ukulele. But now that Crash is back, it's like the whole resurgence of the entire genre. I wouldn't be surprised if we see Spyro or something next.
Spyro Skylanders.
Oh, is that what that is?
That's what the, yeah. That's the Spyro series has gone to Skylanders.
I think I knew that.
I see the mascot platformer coming back, and I see JRPGs coming back in a big way, but I see JRPGs coming back on the indie scene much more than a AAA scene. which okay, I want to go back to Final Fantasy 15 for a second. My gripe with the Final Fantasy series is that I think 10 was the last good battle system. For 14 doesn't really count because it has the MMO battle system.
Mm-hmm.
But 12, 13, 12, 12 and 13 really tried
was
to
11,
make it,
14
11,
14?
Yeah, 11 was the MMO.
Previous MMO.
They finally shut down the server. Like, this was a while ago.
Bad game.
I don't know why you say that.
It was. That's why they had to fix it.
It was not a bad game.
It was a terrible game. That's why they had to make 14.
Wrong.
Realm Reborn. Why else would they make a Realm Reborn?
Because 11 came out in 2002.
11 was not good.
You're so wrong.
Okay.
Did you play it?
Yeah.
Okay.
During my MMO phase.
Anyway.
Skylanders, Imaginators, announced for 2016 release with full customizable characters. Crash Bandicoot DLC. LEGO Star Wars Force Awakens trailer was shown. No gameplay, but it's just another LEGO game. So.
The battle system in Final Fantasy XV looks like something out of Kingdom Hearts, which is good, but bad. That's my gripe.
We're not talking about that.
I just brought that up, and then you complained about 11.
Star Wars. What are you talking about?
You just complained about 11.
Yeah, but we're not. We're moving on. Doesn't matter. Kojima's in the house. Kojima Productions is a Sony first-party studio, and they have Death Stranding with Norman Reedus. There
no
was nothing
play.
Else. It was just a trailer of five dudes above the ocean. But Kojima's in the house, so that's hype. Spider-Man for PS4, not done by Sucker Punch, as I would have thought. Because, like, it makes sense. Sucker Punch has just been making superhero games for since Infamous 1, so why not? But it's going to be Insomniac, which is interesting. But the gameplay looks pretty solid what we saw.
Yeah, definitely.
There hasn't been a Spider-Man console game in a while, except for the movie tie-ins, but those are all I'm talking about, like, the last real one was probably Spider-Man 2.
But that was also a movie tie-in. I don't think there's ever
that
been...
was a good movie tie-in. That's like the best movie game of all time.
I agree. I don't think that there's been a
the only good movie game
non-movie Spider-Man game. Spider-Man game.
Spider-movie.
Do you think that's going to be released coinciding with Homecoming, the new Spider-Man movie?
Was there no release date?
I don't remember.
Nope, it wasn't. That's what it said. I guess then, yeah, there's a possibility. Unless they announce a release date, that's different.
Yeah.
And
then the last thing was Days Gone.
The extended end of Days Gone, which is... That made me not care about it. Yeah.
I'm so sick of zombies.
So let's go ahead and rate our top... Let's do like top two most excited things out of the conference. And then we'll do this for Nintendo as well tomorrow. So
I'm gonna go three.
We'll do three. There's not that many to.
There's a lot. There's enough to make a top three.
I don't think we should do three. But.
Okay, I'm gonna do three anyway. Number three, Death. Fuck, Death Rise. Not Death Rising. God damn it. Death Standing. Stranding. Death Stranding. Took me a minute. Death Stranding. Number two. Probably Crash. No. Number two is 15. Final Fantasy 15. And then... Shit, no. Number three, Death Stranding. Number two, Last Guardian. Number one, Resident Evil 7. I stand by that.
Hmm. I'd probably go three, like... Well, I was just going to do all the VR stuff, but I can't really do that. So I'd probably go Batman VR, just because I'm really curious as to how it's going to work. Because there was no gameplay.
Mm-mm.
But, like, so I might be biting my tongue when they actually release gameplay demo. But, like, that's the premise of Batman VR really intrigues me. Two would probably be, actually, that new God of War trailer that really brought me in. I've never cared about God of War in the past at all, but, like, that was a really good gameplay demo. I like the, I want to say the camera angle, like, feels different.
Yeah.
It looked
more dynamic.
It looked more like a modern third-person action game than the old... Yeah, because God of War had the same style. Like, the camera was
out. The 3D beat-em-up.
Yeah.
Camera.
Yeah. And then... Number one is a toss-up between the Kojima stuff, just because I have no idea what... Like, that's so hype, but I have no idea what that's going to be. Or the Horizon Zero Dawn gameplay. Cause
that's
actually,
fair.
Like, because I've been looking for an open-world, like, exploring and shooting-type game that's not Far Cry.
Mm.
And... I don't want to compare them like directly, but the map did look like a Far Cry sort of ordeal.
The Kojima stuff was like low on my, well, it's number 3 on my list just because it's not like tangible yet to me. It's still a concept. It's not a game yet. Hmm. Whereas RE7 has a demo and Last Guardian like has something behind it. Other than that, closing thoughts?
That was a pretty good conference overall. They didn't spend time doing anything stupid. There was I think it was last year or maybe the year before, where they all sat Indian style on a rug and talked about this one game. I think it was Wonder Book, when Wonder Book came out, and they spent like 30 minutes on it, and it was just absurd.
I don't know what you're talking about.
They all sat Indian style on a rug.
That was weird. I don't remember anything about that game.
Yeah, 2012. Okay.
Holy shit, that was a while ago.
It's rough. It's really rough. I'm not going to watch all of this, but...
No.
I was trying to pull up the...
yeah, I remember this. Sitting. I don't remember...
Wonderbook was pretty hype, and then...
I don't remember seeing anything, like, after this. Did it come out?
Oh, God. They're all sitting.
Oh, that's why it was for the Move.
Yeah.
Okay, that's why...
It was released, but...
Zero idea what this is.
Cool, well... Yeah, no, I think it was definitely a good pace, except I wish they didn't spend too much time on Days Gone, because we don't even have a release date, and it's so, Ben, Sony bend is hype, just because I remember when I thought it was going to be a new Siphon Filter.
Yeah, I don't know.
No.
I've never played a Siphon Filter game.
They're all old PlayStation stuff, but overall, pretty good conference, a lot of stuff on the horizon.
Yeah.
Zero Dawn. You know, we'll be with you tomorrow for Nintendo, noon, high noon. It's high noon.